But welcome again to Joseph Bartholomew Golf Course. We are here for another great project that many of us have been working on for a very, very long time. As you know, we are on the grounds of a historic course that has been rebuilt and is playing at a very, very high level and has been a great asset for this community. And now we're coming back for a second round of major improvements on the clubhouse, which is what we're here to do the groundbreaking for today. And so I'm here with the council member from my district, Cynthia Head Morales. Nice to see you. Representative Jared Brossette and Representative Wesley Fishing, who have been great partners for us. We also have Mike Womack, who's the director of the FEMA Louisiana Recovery Office. Pat Forbes, again, is with us from the Office of Community Development. Deputy Mayor Cedric Grant, the entire team of capital projects, who continue to pull a very, very heavy load and do an incredible job. Vince Smith is with us today. Ms. Ann McDonald, who's the director of Park and Parkways. And Harold Smith, who is Joseph Bartholomew's great grandson. And of course, all the men and women that work out at Joseph Bartholomew on the grounds to course construction. Thank all of you for all the work that you have done. And of course, all of the individuals that take care of and watch this club from day to day, right? All of our rangers. I thank you all for being here today. As many of us know, Joseph Bartholomew was a golf and civil rights pioneer. In 1881, he was born in New Orleans. He caddied at the Audubon Golf Course. He was one of the best golfers, Tom included, in the city. He helped design the City Park courses, number one and two. In 1956, he was the first African-American to design and build a public golf course in the United States of America. And of course, we're here to continue to honor him and his family. And hope that the construction of this new clubhouse will honor his memory as well. Today we're breaking ground on a $4.3 million clubhouse. And as I have said many, many times, we're not just building a building, we're building a place. And if you take a minute just to look around, you not only have a state-of-the-art golf course, but you have behind us a state-of-the-art tennis facility. You have next to us a state-of-the-art baseball facility that we partner with Major League Baseball on. You have down the street a state-of-the-art basketball court that has been put back in shape in partnership with the Pelicans and the Hornets. You also have a recreation facility. You have ballparks, and of course, you're next to SUNO. So this is an unbelievable place that is in the heart of the oldest African-American community in the city of New Orleans, Pontchartrain Park, which is being rebuilt house by house as a result of our $52 million soft seconds program, because this is a very, very important part of the city. Again, we're retaining the neighborhood legacy that we have built so long. I could go through the whole long list of projects that were built, but suffice it to say, it's been a fairly extensive investment that is going to be capped off by the Walmart that will again be adjoined with the new school that's being built, and then we'll have this community center. And this historic neighborhood will come roaring back as it is in the process of doing it. It would not be possible without the help of all of the people that are standing with us today. So I'm thrilled to be here. This is another down payment on a commitment that the city of New Orleans made to rebuilding the neighborhood.